It's called Plandemic, a 25-minute video claiming to show the real story behind COVID-19. YouTube is deleting it for violating guidelines on COVID misinformation, but that hasn't stopped tens of millions of people from sharing it on other platforms. So we're gonna dive into this, but first, we wanna focus on who is putting this together. On their website, the creators say the purpose of Plandemic is to, quote, expose the scientific and political elite who run the scam that is our global health system, while laying out a new plan that allows all of humanity to reconnect with healing forces of nature. So they've got a message they're trying to send, and they do it in this snappy-looking documentary. Let's go.
Dr. Michovitz published a blockbuster article in the journal Science. The controversial article sent shockwaves through the scientific community as it revealed that the common use of animal and human fetal tissues were unleashing devastating plagues of chronic diseases. For exposing their deadly secrets, the minions of Big Pharma waged war on Dr. Michovitz.
Okay, we're 45 seconds in and we have to stop. Dr. Judy Michovitz was a researcher at the National Cancer Institute, and in 2009, at a different research institute, she published a study in the journal Science. But that study was retracted 2 years later and Michovitz was fired. The video claims it was for exposing deadly secrets. That's false. 10 independent studies tried to recreate Michovitz's study. They all failed. So the journal retracted it and said the first test likely had contaminated samples. Let's keep going.
The game is to prevent the therapies till everyone is infected and push the vaccines, knowing that the flu vaccines increase the odds by 36% of getting COVID-19.
Stop there. This is false. The flu vaccine does not increase the chances of getting COVID-19 by 36%. That claim comes from a misrepresented study. The real study by the Department of Defense was testing whether the flu shot made you more likely to get other viruses. But after testing, the conclusion was no. The flu vaccine didn't increase the odds. And that study was in 2017, before COVID-19 existed. Back to the video.
Wearing the mask literally activates your own virus. You're getting sick from your own reactivated coronavirus expressions. And if it happens to be SARS-CoV-2, then you've got a big problem.
Let's stop here. This is false. In another interview, Michovitz explained her belief that the virus doesn't spread from person to person, but instead gets injected with vaccines.
It's plausible, it's probable that it's been in every flu vaccine since 13 to 15, as that's when this work was being illegally done.
She believes the virus has been dormant in our bodies for years and that masks are causing it to, quote, activate. There is no evidence to support this claim. There are reasons it's false, like COVID testing. Millions of people worldwide are getting COVID tests. If this was a dormant virus in our bodies, the tests would still show it. There would be no negative results from anyone who's ever had a flu shot. And the idea that masks activated the virus doesn't add up either. The CDC and WHO initially didn't advise people wear masks, and for weeks, the virus was still spreading worldwide. So claim false. All right. One more time.
The AMA was saying, you know, doctors will lose their license if they use hydroxychloroquine.
No, they did not say that. The AMA put out guidelines urging doctors be cautious using hydroxychloroquine, but they didn't threaten to revoke medical licenses because they can't. The AMA confirmed that they're a voluntary membership organization, not a regulatory one, and they have no control over licenses. And we're gonna stop there. This video is snappy and well-produced, but it's trying to push a narrative filled with falsehoods and a lack of evidence, meaning we classify this video as disinformation. With your Verify, I'm Jason Puckett.